About 10 years ago, we could be doing this. We could be doing a webinar on the internet with video, with demos, with IM chat. Now, we'd have to be at major corporations. We'd have to have new big machines with the right cards and functionality and a back-end server, whatever that is. And then maybe we could do it and have a webinar. Or we'd pay someone several thousands of dollars to come in and do the webinar and produce the webinar for us. In this day and age, it literally takes a touch of a button on many different devices to get IM chat, to get face-to-face talk, to do meetings on various devices with various programs. Today, we're going to show you what we do with Lync. Lync has been part of the Office suite for several years. Before that, it was called Communicator. And we'll show you how you can work with Lync. We're going to use Lync 2013. We'll show you how you can make a better meeting, I think at least. And we can show you how a little behind the scenes of how we do a webinar on Lync. We're using the same Lync that anyone else can use to do these webinars. First, I just want to kind of move over here to show you how to get Lync right now if you don't have it. Again, some companies, when we have people on the live call talking about how they are using Lync, an earlier version of Lync or whatever. Office 365 comes in various levels for business. So there's small business, medium size, and bigger, what's called enterprise. And all of those include Lync. There that you can find it. So you get the app Office applications. You can buy it for the small business here. It's a monthly fee of $12.50 per user. So even again, a company of one could use this and use Lync. And you can actually try it now. So if you wanted to, you could try Office 365 for business, and later today you could do your own webinar. Maybe we'll tune in. So let's just go through a couple basic steps with Lync. Now, Lync is like when dealing with Outlook and Exchange and all that. Different versions will have different features if you're on an earlier version of Lync. So maybe this doesn't look all the same, but several of the core functionality should be the same. This is Outlook 2013 that you should be seeing here in just a moment. When you do an appointment in Outlook in the calendar, you go up to the top and click New Appointment, but you can also click New Lync Meeting. And what that does is generate the materials you need. Now, I'm connected to a corporation, so I have a certain number of information that's popped in here, like phone numbers that are for Microsoft and all that. But again, this same core information should be there. And for people that click on Join Lync Meeting, they would join. Now, if they don't have a Lync, which most people on the live call don't, you'll get a Lync web app. And the web apps work just like the Office web apps. You don't have to have Office, but you can get some of the core functionality with the Lync web app. So that way you'll know that everyone, even if they don't have Lync or do have Lync, they'll be able to join your meeting. Some people need to get call in for audio, and that's what the numbers are there for. So this I would send out to anyone I wanted to in the meeting, in the company and outside the company. It wouldn't matter. Let's go over and look at Lync here. Now, this is, again, kind of funky because I can't really demo as much as I want because I'm using Lync to do this webinar, so it's going to be kind of not the prettiest one, but I'll try to get through this part really quickly to show you some functionality and then get into some of other things. I just didn't want to show a whole bunch of slides. So this is the Lync screen. I've turned off things like chat and the attendee list and all that. I'm going to turn that on really quick just so you can see it. But again, I'm just going to turn that off so it's less of a distraction to me. But again, some of these keys you kind of roll over and you can get, you can see certain things. So if I roll over this one in the bottom corner for, I can see my participants there if I want to. And there's also actions. Now, one of the things that you can turn things on and off, there's actually meeting. When you set up the meeting in Outlook, if you have Outlook available, you can set these meeting options up in advance if you want to. So you can mute the whole audience, which is really important if you're doing a large meeting. You don't want the audience talking, or you want to control that. So you can control that in Outlook when you set up the meeting, or here in Lync when you run the meeting. The camera one's kind of interesting. Now, I'm not going to click this. I'm just going to mouse over, and I'm actually now seeing in the bottom left-hand corner a preview, and this is the camera that's on my actual computer, not the camera we have plugged in. You can set which camera you want up with Lync, but the nice thing is I can preview that, and if I don't look good, if I have a bad hair day, which is most days, I don't have to turn on the video. I can preview it first. The main thing, though, with Lync is what you can add for functionality. So here I can share my desktop, which I'm doing right now. I can share just an individual program. PowerPoint we were just showing a little bit earlier. Let me click whiteboard. You can actually do a whiteboard in a meeting. And you can put a picture in there, or you can just start talking and drawing things. And again, I knew some people would start that. Actually, anyone can draw right now if they wanted to. And I could just leave the camera on the whiteboard here for 15 minutes and have a lot of fun time, but I'm going to knock that off. Sorry, gang. Nope, I'm not going to do it right now. I got to hit this again. I'm going to go over and the polls are part of the program. So, oh man, there we go. Hello from Germany. I saw that. So this is a Lync poll that we have. If you haven't voted, you can vote again. We're just wanting to know if your company had Lync. We're not keeping this and you're going to get a sales call. Don't worry about that. But you can do instant polls in Lync. You can have them pre-made like I did, or just do one on the fly. And this has been some of the more interesting things about trying to figure out certain questions that you're trying to poll your audience for. Some in Lync 2013, there's also a Q&A feature. So it's just you talking to the masses versus in a chat. The main thing, though, is to share, again, content and other things. Let me go over and also show a couple of things you can do with Lync. So the nice thing about Lync is the same interface works if I'm talking one-to-one, doing a meeting, or doing a webinar. It's not different interfaces. So what I'm going to do here, let's see here. Let me go back to showing my desktop here. And let's say I wanted to talk to Dave about something else. I could do it two ways. If Dave's in the meeting, I can certainly click him in here. I can even make people presenters, and they can take control over of my screen and present. So you have multiple presenters that are remote. The other thing you can do is I'm going to do this and actually going to bring in Dave this way. So I'm in a meeting right now, but I can still talk to Dave in private. Now you're seeing my desktop, so it's not in private. So Dave could be anywhere. Let's say Dave's on a beach in Hawaii. He's just actually in the room with me. But so I can continue on with my meeting or watching the meeting or even presenting the meeting and still working with Dave in IM. And again, I have the same controls down here. Now I'm not going to start the audio or the video because that would bounce me out of the webinar. But again, I can have a conversation with folks while I'm doing other things. Now, one of the things you can do with meetings and Lync is years ago, there's always a kickoff meeting. We all got in a room. We all talked about, okay, we're going to plan next quarter, or we're going to plan the boss's birthday. And maybe someone would bring out a computer and start the spreadsheet, and then I'll pass it to you tomorrow, and you'll get it on maybe Thursday. With Lync and using Office or the web apps, you can get a lot of stuff done. And you can just do the stuff in the meeting. So what I want to do here is, let's say we have to plan the boss's birthday. So I'm going to go into, I'm bringing up SkyDrive here. We'll let that render here real quick. And I'm going to open an invite because I have to do this. We have, the boss, every year we have to do this for the boss. Rawr. And one thing I can do now, we're both in Word 2013, so we could do this in Word 2013, but I wanted to show you in the web apps, because again, if you have folks that don't have later versions of Office, you can do this all in the free web app. So I'm going to go to File and share this Lync and share this with people. And what I'm going to do, we can do this a little slower just for time's sake. I'm going to create a URL. And then I could send that to everyone in the meeting, or in this case, I'm going to send it to Dave. And then what I'm going to do my favorite thing about Windows, starting with Windows 7, is you can snap these windows. Every 20-year-old knows how to do this, so they can watch videos and do their homework at the same time. So we could chat, again, we could do this audio-wise, but we could chat in IM. And we could both work on this document. So I've invited Dave into the document. And we could work on a document. And again, this could be a spreadsheet. This could be anything that's the web apps are Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote. Let's see. And if I click over here back to this, let me go full frame on this. Pink is the boss's favorite color. Interesting. Are you in the document, Dave?
It's loading.
Okay. So usually what would happen here is it would say that two people are sharing the document. I can edit the document in the web app. Dave can, we can be in the document at the same time. You can do this in Excel. You can do this with other folks. So, yeah, for time's sake, I'm going to jump out of it, though, because I want to show, there we go, Dave Ludwig is editing this document. So we can edit this document. You can do this with multiple people. So instead of passing this thing around, you can do Lync. Everyone can be in five different places at once. You can communicate to each other, work on documents at the same time, and get things done instead of just having a meeting about getting things done. I want to move back really quickly and just talk a little bit about how we do webinars here. So I'm going to just show a picture here, kind of a setup that we have, because I'm using the same Lync that any corporation would use for Lync with Lync 2013. There's nothing special that we're doing. There's other things that we're doing that are kind of special that add for a better webinar. One of the things that happens with webinars is they're recorded, and usually the recording is compressed in such a way that once you see it, and if you go back to some of their early webinars, you'll see that. You'll see webinars that are done with the Lync recordings. We're recording this. I didn't show you those controls, but Chris is actually recording the webinar right now. And then, but the sound, and if you ever listen to webinars, you know that tinny sound that sounds like this. It sounds bad, but you get used to it after a while. And if you watch a lot of lectures or webinars, you see that and you're used to it. But when you put this video up on, let's say, YouTube, the sound is going to be awful. So we record differently. There's a lot of duplication for what we're doing. This is the setup we used to have in the same room. Chris there is on the left. He runs the technical side of things. He has the headphones in or the earplugs so he can listen to what you're hearing. So he can tell me if my mic's off, or he can, if someone else has a mic on, or if we're doing an interview, he can monitor that. He's got the toughest job because he hears me in his headset a moment after I actually say it. He's got the toughest job here. So big hand for Chris. But other things that we're doing here. So I have this microphone, this silver microphone, and one thing you can do with PowerPoint is just like on the whiteboard, you can annotate this. So I can put this little stamp here by this microphone. So this microphone that you can see on camera is plugged into the monitor. I'm not using the mic in the laptop because this gives you a better sound live. But again, it's going to sound tinny if I use the Lync recording and put that up. So we have this other mic, which is just off camera. Actually, you can see it in the camera shot here. This microphone here picks up and goes into a digital recorder. So we record audio two different ways. So that's one thing to think about with webinars. Is it mostly just for the live crowd? And maybe you'll put the recording up and no one will watch it. Or most people will watch the recording and you want a really good recording. So you want to do some duplication. Same thing, we have two cameras. I'm not using the camera that's in this laptop. It's a pretty good camera, but you saw the preview earlier. You just see my chin for 15 minutes. Nobody wants to do that. So we put this little small camera up here on a tripod on the desk. And that's what the live crowd's seeing. Now, if you're watching this recording later on our blog or at YouTube, it's actually the camera behind that that's not in this picture you're seeing, that Bruce is recording it on a high-definition camera. That's, now, this is an HD camera too, but it's a much better quality. And I'm actually, I cheat. I actually look at Bruce's camera the entire time. I'm not looking at you. But because the live feed in Lync is so small, you don't notice the difference. Now I'm looking at you. Now I'm looking at Bruce's camera. Not a big difference. We just kind of line up the cameras. So again, the live crowd sees one shot. The recording crowd will see a different, better shot. And that's how we kind of work on the duplication. There's also two computers here. I do everything on this black computer, but I carry, you can see it on the live shot, this camera, this is monitors things, so I can kind of see what you're seeing. Chris and I plug into Ethernet, so we have the best possible connection. This goes wireless. We could do everything wireless, but when you present, you want to try to do the best thing. So you want to make sure you're powered in. You want to make sure you have an Ethernet connection. There's more things that we do with the webinar, but again, we're using Lync the way you could use Lync to do your own webinars. And you can go to office.com and get Office 365 and try it, and you could be doing this later today, literally. Now, if you want to do the duplication, you'd have to bring in a nice camera, get the nice mic, but it can be done with all the equipment that you have. But for now, we're going to wrap up things because 15 minutes flies by. We'll have the recording up so you can compare if you want to. Later this week at aka.ms/link123, we'll also have information, and links are already there about how to use Lync. If you have questions, you can put questions in there also. For the Office webinar series, go to aka.ms/offweb. You can find a listing of upcoming webinars, look at previous webinars, and go ahead and leave us comments on what you'd like to see there. Next week, Dave's back in the hot seat and we'll be talking about Project. But for today's webinar team, thank you for joining this Office 15-Minute Webinar.